How to learn to code is a big question, and there's no one right answer. Say you were interested in art. What does that mean specifically? Do you want to draw portraits, make sculptures, paint murals? If you don't have a clear goal, what to do next is bound to be elusive. In this video, I'll talk about how to get started learning to code for the web, using online and other self-guided resources, how to determine your goal, pick a language, and stay motivated to keep learning. I won't discuss learning to code through formal education or in-person boot camps. For that, you'll want to research different programs at colleges, universities, and developer boot camps near you. The first question you'll want to ask yourself is, why do I want to learn to code? What's my end goal? To switch careers, or to get a better job or a promotion? To build a specific application, start a business, or simply for fun? When I decided to learn how to code, my goal was to switch careers and find a more challenging, higher-paying job. I chose front-end web development. Because I had a bit of experience building websites, so I knew I enjoyed it, the job market was hot, and there were a ton of online resources to help me learn it. How you learn how to code will depend greatly on your goal. If your goal is to switch careers or start a new career, begin by researching the job market in your area, remote opportunities, and anywhere you're willing or able to move. Look at job ads on sites like Indeed or Dice.com. Consult your local employment office for statistics and information about local opportunities and training programs. What languages and skills are employers looking for? Research the job market to get a general idea for what skills might be good to have, but keep in mind that employers tend to ask for the moon. Don't forget to follow your interests and give yourself the time and space to explore and figure out what interests you. Front-end web development is a great path for those looking to switch or start a new career. You'll learn HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, which will get you started building websites and web applications. HTML is used to structure a web page's content. CSS is used to visually style a web page. And JavaScript is used to add interactivity to a web page. If you'd like to broaden your horizons beyond front-end web development, you might consider learning Python. Python is a popular first language to learn because it has a straightforward, easy-to-learn syntax. It's a good general-purpose language with a strong community, many online resources, and lots of job opportunities around the world. If you have an idea in mind for an application you'd like to build, a good question to ask yourself is, where will it run? If you want to build a mobile app, consider learning Swift to develop on Apple products, and Kotlin or Java to develop for Android devices. You can also write mobile applications with JavaScript, using tools like React Native, though learning Swift or Kotlin is needed to unlock the full potential of apps on a mobile device. If you want to build an application that will run in a web browser, you'll need JavaScript plus a language that will help you interact with the database. JavaScript can also be used for that when paired with Node.js. Some other options include Python, Java, C#, Ruby, and PHP. If you're trying to get a startup or small business up and running, perhaps your goal is to learn just enough code to be able to communicate in a meaningful way with your developers. You might research which technologies are popular in your specific industry, or you might choose a language like Python that's often used for educational purposes due to its relatively straightforward syntax and ease of learning. Whatever your goal and whichever language you choose, don't stress. Lots of beginners get caught up in which languages or technologies to learn first. While it's definitely helpful to put some thought into which one best fits your goals, choosing your first language is not a lifelong commitment. Most programming languages are centered around the same fundamental concepts. So if you discover a particular one isn't exactly right for you, picking up a second language will be much easier than learning your first. In other words, nothing you learn will be in vain. You've determined your goal and picked a language. Now what? It's easy to feel like you can't make progress if you don't have a 4-hour block of time to sit down and really dig into coding. The reality is, however, that even setting aside 15 minutes every day adds up and will keep you moving forward and in the habit of learning. Establish a routine to help you stay on track. For example, I start every morning by reading an article or watching a conference talk about programming. This helps me get my head in the game and in the mindset to learn. Sometimes this turns into an hours-long coding session, and sometimes it doesn't. But the point is that I walk away every day knowing more than I did yesterday. Challenges like 100 days of code are awesome for helping you stay motivated. The basic idea is that you commit to a minimum amount of coding every day and post about what you learned to social media. You then get encouragement and support from other challenge participants. Finding a group of people, be it virtual or in person, is vital when learning to code. Participating in a community means you can share resources, help each other work through difficult problems, and just have a shoulder to cry on when things get challenging. Organizations like Code Newbie and Free Code Camp are excellent ways to meet other people who are also learning how to code. Be sure to look for coding meetups in your area. Start attending early and often. Try not to feel too intimidated as a beginner. You'll meet plenty of other beginners, and even if the meetup topic is a little advanced, it's still an opportunity to get to know people and gain industry exposure. The best way to learn to code is simply to do it. Do coding exercises on sites like CodeSignal and CodeWars. Build a portfolio website, chip away at a larger project that interests you, or build a website for a friend, family member, or your cat. If you're unsure of what to do as a coding project, look around you and ask yourself, what problem can I solve with code? It doesn't have to be anything huge. For example, when I was learning to code, I volunteered to build a simple website for a local nonprofit. This gave me valuable experience working with clients and thinking about web development from the user's perspective. When I attended a coding bootcamp, I built a simple application that helped my fellow classmates queue up questions for our instructor. One of the funnest projects I created played triumphant music at the press of a button, so that my classmates could celebrate their coding wins. The important part is to keep at it, practice, and have fun with it. While you're studying, learning, and practicing, mistakes will be made, errors will occur, and small typos will trip you up for hours. Rest assured that this is all part of the learning process. As you learn, study, and gain more experience, you'll get better at debugging, become more familiar with best practices, and build up skill and logical thinking. Try to embrace the struggle as part of the process. Learning to code is difficult, but you can do it. Asking for help is really important. Getting stuck on a problem and hammering away for hours on a project is a valuable part of the learning process, but so is learning how to use the resources available to you. Make good use of the thousands of tutorials, articles, and blog posts out there. Search the web for any problems or error messages you encounter. Nearly any question you can think of has already been asked and answered on forums like Stack Overflow or the Treehouse community. Use these resources to your advantage. Even the most experienced developer searches the web and consults documentation all the time. If you're new to code, there are tons of online resources for you to try things out. Expect to learn from multiple sources. That means online courses, reference materials like documentation, blogs, and articles, as well as reading books and working on your own projects. Rarely will you learn everything from a single source. Free resources out there include Khan Academy, Free Code Camp, and YouTube. If you want something more structured, I recommend Treehouse. Treehouse offers structured learning paths that were designed specifically for people who are new to code. Treehouse is a great place to start because we offer multiple languages, so you can explore the one that's best for you. We offer dozens of learning tracks with fun, friendly, and informative videos, quizzes, and code challenges to help you stay focused and motivated. You'll also gain access to guided practice sessions and coding by example. It's a pretty comprehensive online school that costs only $25 a month. To give it a try, click the link in the description, and maybe I'll see you there. I'm one of the teachers.